Hello children, today we will do revision 2. Yes, today we will do class 3 SST chapter 17, Life of the Early Man. This is the first part and it is a history chapter and we call it revision 2. Okay. It has been long back, isn't it, that we have finished Life of the Early Man, part 1. We have discussed so many things in the chapters, isn't it? I hope so that you all understand. If not, so let us quickly recapitulate what we have done so far. And we will brush our memory very quickly. Okay. So, before starting our questions and answers that we will discuss today, which is the most important part, today we will have discussion on the question and answers from within the chapters as well as on the back of the question of the chapter and some of the questions that we will discuss from back of the chapter and from within the chapters there are few questions that I have given for you all to solve it out. Okay, so first let us quickly brush it up whatever we have studied in the Life of the Early Man part 1. So, the Life of the Early Man, we did this chapter, Life of the Early Man, isn't it? You all know, you all have this book, so you all can go through this book even. It is on page 93. So, we have learned from this chapter that man lived on the earth more than how many years ago? 400,000 years ago, isn't it? And that is why he is known as early man, because it is at very early time, isn't it, that he lived, many thousands and thousands and thousands of years before that we are talking about, where this early man lived, isn't it? Their life was very hard. They were wanderers. Wanderers means people who move from one place to another in search of something. Okay, and early men were wanderers because they searched for the food, and so they moved from one place to another. They had no permanent houses to live because they were wanderers, and they did not know how to cook because they did not know how to make fire at that time. At early age, people did not know how to make fire. Later on, quite later on, they learned how to make fire. So at those time, he did not know how to make fire. He had no clothes to wear. He had no permanent house. And he used to move from one place to another like wanderers in search of food. So their life was at great risk, isn't it? Risk of animals, wild animals attacking them during night. Again, they had to face the heat, cold, rain, isn't it? And thus their life was full of miseries and sorrows, and they had to face lots of diseases, and their life was always at risk of being attacked by some huge wild animals. So, as they evolved and they became better and better, they learned how to protect themselves. How they protected themselves, how they hunted, they used stone weapons, stone tools, isn't it? With the help of stones, and those times there was no iron, there was no other metals with which they could use. They all discovered these things later on as they evolved to become better and better. But at those times, there was nothing around them. They could only find was what? Big stones and rocks, and they made use of that. And with the help of stones and rocks, they used them to make into weapons, tools. And with the help of those stone tools, they used to protect themselves from the wild animals, as well as they used to hunt the animals. Why they hunted animals? For food. And they ate those animals raw. Why they ate raw? I have told you all earlier, because at those times, they did not know how to make fire. So, they used to eat their food raw. Whatever fruits, whatever vegetables, whatever roots, whatever meat, they used to eat it raw. They used to kill animals and they used to eat it raw. Got it? So, the life of early man was really very miserable, really very saddened one, isn't it? There was nothing, but slowly they learned. They were great learners, great observers, and slowly they learned. He was afraid of wild animals like lions, tigers, elephants, because they were huger, bigger than them, isn't it? They were huge than them, like elephants, tigers, bears. They were huge as well as more stronger than them. That is why they were afraid of those animals. Got it? But thousands of years passed, and now early men wanted to protect themselves. They were thinking about the protection, and so what they did, they started living in caves. Okay, caves would protect them from heat, cold, rain, isn't it? And also they could block the mouth of the caves with huge rocks so that wild animals could not come during the night while they were sleeping, isn't it? So slowly they were learning. Now they made beautiful drawings on the ceilings and walls of those caves, isn't it, which are found now at the present time also. Okay, and they are of huge, great historical importance to our in the history. Okay, and many years rolled by more, and they learned to make better stone, and he learned to separate the skins of animals. Okay. The skins of animals, they can use it to make their clothes, okay, and many other things also they could make with the skin of animals. Now slowly they discovered fire, which was the greatest, the most important achievement in the life of early man. So they discovered fire, and it was an accidental discovery. Means by chance they had, by an accident they had discovered fire. Once what happened, it might have happened that they were rubbing two stones. They used to make stones, no? Tools. They used to use stone to make tools. So while rubbing the stone together to make some weapons or whatever, he found that sparks were coming out of the stones. And when it was brought near the dry leaves, the sparks, it caught fire. And they had seen fire earlier. So now they could imagine, now they realize that yes, with the help of rubbing of the two stones, they could make fire. So with the help of fire, they were now a better human being, isn't it? Because what happened with the help of invention of fire, what happened, they started protecting themselves, because they saw that other animals like elephants, tigers, lions, they were also afraid of fire, and so they used fire to protect themselves from the attack of wild animals. They could now move at night, because night is very dark, isn't it? So we need light. So fire was used as light for them to travel at night even. And they also found that a piece of meat, when cooked over food, cooked over fire, it becomes more tastier and easy to chew. Chew means to the movement of our mouth when we take a food and started breaking our food, isn't it? That is called chewing with the help of our teeth. Got it? So this is how the life of early men started, and it kept on moving, and they started learning more and more and becoming better and better. Got it? I hope now you all have understood the chapter. You all have got everything into your mind, and we have brushed up all our memories. And now we will start the question answers. There are three sets of questions that I have prepared for you. First one is the long type of questions, where you need to write at least 2 to 3 or 3 to 4 lines. You have to write for the answers. And the next set of questions, that is set number 2, is short answer type. That means 1 or 2 lines you can use to write the answers. And the next, the third set, is objective type of question answers. Okay, 1 word or 2 word you can use to write. You need not write it in full sentence, only 1 or 2 words you need to write in those objective types of questions. Got it? First we will do long questions, then short questions and objectives. Long questions and short questions I will discuss with you. And the objectives, which are very easy, you all can do it by yourself. But first, you all will go through the chapter very carefully and read again. and then you will sit down to answer these questions. So first, let me give you all the first set of question, that is the long set of question. Okay. Yes. Now we have answer the following. These are set one, that is long answer types. Okay. Now we will move on to the first question, that is where did the early man live? Got it? Let me repeat the question for you once again. Where did the early man live? You all will copy down all these questions and you all will write the answers, okay? As we are discussing, you all can jot down the points as we are discussing. Where did the early man live? So, where did the early man live? The early man had houses to live. They had permanent houses like us. They used to stay in bungalow flats. No, no. They were early men and they had no permanent house to live. So, where did they live? They lived in forest. And he also lived on the ground and in trees. Okay. So, what you will write? The early man lived in forest. He had no permanent home to live in. He lived on the ground and in trees. Okay. You all have got the answers. Let me repeat once again. The early man lived in the forest. He had no permanent house to live and he lived on the ground and in trees. Okay. Now next question. You have got the first answer. Now question number two. Why did the early man eat his food raw? Let me repeat the question. Why did the early man eat his food raw? So, why he ate his food raw? Because at that time, had he discovered fire? No. At that time, he did not know how to make fire. So, that is why he could not cook his food. And so, he used to eat his food raw. Okay. Because on fire only we can cook food, no? And at that time, they did not know how to make fire. So, that is why they used to eat their food raw. So, how you will write your answer? You will write that the early man ate his food raw because he could not make a fire. And so, he used to eat his food raw. Okay. So, as early man could not make his food, could not make fire. Now, question number 3. We will do question number 3. Question number 3 is, why did the early man started living in caves? So, he did not have a permanent house and he had to bear the heat, cold, rain, everything, isn't it? So, slowly he started thinking that he should protect himself from heat, cold and rain. Thus, he started living in caves. Got it? So, you will write how you will write your answers. The early man wanted to protect himself from heat, cold, rain and wild animals. So, he started living in caves. Got it? How you will write your answer? Why did the early man start living in caves? Question number 3. You will write, the early man wanted to protect himself from heat, cold, rain and wild animals. So, he started living in caves. Got it? Now, we will move to question number 4. How did the early man learn to make fire? How did the early man learn to make fire? So, fire, he did not make it purposely, isn't it? He had made fire accidentally. Okay. So, what happened? What you will write? That the discovery of fire was accidental. While making tools, he rubbed two stones together and they produced sparks. It touched dry leaves and things and burst into a flame. This is how they learned how to make fire. Okay. So, again, let me say, repeat the question. How did the early man learn to make fire? You will write, the discovery of fire was accidental. While making tools, He rubbed two stones together and they produced sparks. It touched dry leaves and things and burst into a flame. Got it? Have you all understood what you have to write in question number 4? Now we will move to question number 5. How was fire useful to the early man? Now they have made fire. And they slowly learned how fire was helpful to them. How was fire helpful? Firstly, the fire would protect them from the wild animals, isn't it? From the attack of wild animals, because wild animals were also afraid of fire. Okay. Now, next, they could use fire to make themselves warm during the cold nights, isn't it? During cold season, when they used to feel very cold, they could sit beside the fire and get the warmth of the fire. Got it? So, two things we have learned. First is what? They would protect themselves from the wild animals with the use of fire. Second, they used to keep themselves warm with the help of fire. And thirdly, what happened? By accident, what happened? A piece of meat or flesh fell into the fire. And later when they took it out, they found that it was much tastier and easy to chew. Okay, so now they learned what we call cooking of food. So there are 3 points that you have to write. First, they used fire to protect themselves against the wild animals. Second, they used fire to warm their body during the cold nights. And also thirdly, they cooked their food on fire. Okay, so these 3 points you will take, these 3 hints I have given you, you will frame your own answer with the help of these 3 hints. Okay, so these were your set of long questions. So first is, where did the early man live? This is the first question. Okay, second, why did the early man eat his food raw? Got it? Question number 3. Why did the early man started living in caves? Question number 4. How did the early man learn to make fire? And question number 5. How was the fire useful to the early man? Got it? I hope you all have understood the hints that I have given you all. With the help of those hints, with the help of those points, you can frame your own answers. Okay. Now we will move on to the short questions. Yes, now see, these are your short questions. Let us go on to the first question. Who are early man? These are the short questions. You will have to write it one to two lines. Okay. Who are early men? Who are early men, children? Man lived on earth more than 400,000 years ago. He was known as early man. So man who lived 400,000 years ago, they are known as early man. Got it? Only you have to write this sentence. Okay. Man who lived on the earth more than 400,000 years ago, they are known as early man. Got it? Now we will move to question number 2. How did the early man kill the wild animals? So, I have already told you all that early men used to eat, hunt animals and eat their flesh raw, isn't it? So, how did the early men kill wild animals? With their bare hands? No, they used some tools, isn't it? So, what you will write? He unhunted wild animals with sharp stones and ate their flesh. So, with which they used to hunt animals, kill the wild animals. The early man killed wild animals with the help of sharp stones. Got it? So, what will be your answer? What is the question? How did the early man kill the wild animals? The answer will be, the early man killed the wild animals with the help of sharp stones. Okay. Now we will move on to question number 3. What did the early man use to cover his body? What did the early man use to cover his body? They were early men, they did not have clothes, isn't it? So they covered his body with what? They covered his body with leaves and bark of trees. So the early man had no clothes to put on. He covered his body with leaves and bark of trees. You have to just write this. Okay? So what did the early man use to cover his body? The early man had no clothes to put on. He covered his body with leaves and bark of trees. Got it? Now we will move to question number 4. Who are wanderers? I have often spoken about wanderers, early men are wanderers, isn't it? I have also told you all what does the term wanderer mean. So, I expect you all know, but still I am giving you all the answer. The wanderers are people who move from one place to another in search of something. Okay, so what you will write for wanderers, please listen very carefully. Wanderers are people who move from one place to another in search of something. Got it? Let me repeat once again. Who are wanderers? Wanderers are people who move from one place to another in search of something. Now question number 5. Why did the early man wander about? Now early men were wanderers. So why they wandered about? They wandered about in search of food, isn't it? So the early man wandered about in search of food. You will write this one. So why did the early man wander about? The early man wandered about in search of food. Got it? Now next question. Question number 6. Have you seen the early man? Have you seen early man? No, we have not seen because they were born 400,000 years ago. Many thousands of years ago they lived. Now we cannot see early man. Now what we see is a highly civilized man, human being, isn't it? So we have not seen early man. So you will write the answer. We have not seen the early man. We have heard and read about him. Only this two line you have to write. We have, this answer is on page 93. Just the second line. Okay. You will write, we have not seen the early man. We have heard and read about him. Got it? Now question number 7. What did the early man draw on the ceilings of caves? So early man started living in caves, isn't it, to protect himself from heat, cold, rain. So it is also given in the book that he started drawing on the ceilings of caves. Okay, so what did he draw? So most of his drawings were of running wild bisons, bears, horses, etc. So what did the early man draw on the ceilings of the caves? The early man drew drawings of running wild bisons, bears, horses, etc. on the ceilings of the caves. This only you have to write. Okay? Let me repeat once again. Listen very carefully. Question number 7. What did the early man draw on the ceilings of caves? Your answer will be, the early man drew drawings of running wild bisons, bears, horses, etc. on the ceilings of caves. Okay, the early man drew drawings of running wild bisons, bears, horses, etc. on the ceilings of caves. Got it? Now we will move to question number 8. Question 8. The early man learned to make better stone tools. How it helped them? So this line is from the chapter. The early man learned to make better stone tools. As they evolved, they started making better stone tools, isn't it? So how it helped them? So you write, The early man learned to make better stone tools and he learned to separate the skins of wild animals. So the early man learned to make better stone tools and he learned to separate the skin of wild animals. So by learning how to make better stone tools, he started separating the skins of wild animals. Okay, you have got the answers. We have finished 8 questions from the short types of question answers. Okay, let me again repeat the questions for you. Question number 1, who are early man? Question 2, how did the early man kill the wild animals? Question 3, what did the early man use to cover his body? Question 4, who are wanderers? Question 5, why did the early man wander about? Question 6, have you seen the early man? Question 7, what did the early man draw on the ceilings of caves? And question 8, the early man learned to make better stone tools. How it helped them? So, till now we have finished 2 sets of questions. The long question answers and the short question answers. Now, we will continue with the 3rd set of questions, which is objective types of questions. Now, we have this 3rd set of questions, which is objective type of questions. These are objective type of questions. Okay. The first question, let me tell you, before I start with discussing the questions, is that these are the questions which are very, very easy and you have to write it in just 1 or 2 words. Okay. 1 or 2 words. You need not write the answer in full sentence. You will just write 1 or 2 words. Okay. And you will write these answers by yourself. So I will not discuss the answer. I will just read out the questions for you all so that you all can understand what I have written. Okay. For those who cannot understand whatever I have written, I will read out the questions. Okay. So that you all can understand what I have written. Okay. I will explain the question, but I will not give you all the answers because these are very, very easy answers and I hope that you all, every one of you all can write these answers. So, for this you have to go through the chapter as well. You have to go thoroughly to the chapters and if you go thoroughly to the chapters, you will all find the answers to these questions. Okay. So, let us start with the first question. How many years ago did the early man lived on the earth? This is all given on the first page of the chapter. So, you all will all know. When you open the book, you will all know. Okay. You all will all get the answer. So, again, question number 1. How many years ago did the early man lived on the earth? Got it? Now, we move to question number 2. What did the early man eat? What did they eat? You have to write. Okay. Now, question number 3. Which weapons he used to hunt animals? Which weapon he used? Okay. What was the weapon made of? That thing. Okay. Which weapon he used to hunt animals? Now, question number 4. What was the early man afraid of? Early man was afraid of what? You have to write that. Okay. You all know. I know this. That you all know the answers. Question number 5. Rubbing of 2 stones produced what? They rubbed 2 stones, isn't it, to make stone tools and it produced something. So you have to write what it produced. Okay. Question number 6. What was the most important achievement of early man? Which was the most important achievement of early man? In this chapter we have learned, isn't it? Over and again I have told you all that life of early man, in the life of early man, they had achieved very important thing. Isn't it? In this chapter. So you have to write. Question number 7. Name any two animals the early man was afraid of. Names of many animals are given. You just have to write two animals that he was afraid of. That's why I have given name any two. Any two animals the early man was afraid of. Question number 8. Where did the early man started living? At first they started, they had no house. They wandered in the jungle. They lived in jungle. They lived on the grounds and on trees. But later on they started living somewhere. So where did the early man started living? That you have to write. Question number 9 and 10 are types of fill in the blanks. And this also comes under objective type of questions. That is why I have given you two of them. Number 9 is cooked food was much more dashed and dashed to chew. So when they found that when they ate the cooked food, they found that the cooked food was much more what? And it was what to chew. That you have to write. Okay. And last question is he started drawing on dash and dash of caves. So where he started drawing on caves? You have to write that. Okay. I hope you have all understood all the chapters. The chapter you have understood because I have done thoroughly with you all. And the questions also, the three sets of questions. First is the long question, then the short question, and then the objective type of question. These are all three types of questions. I hope you all have understood. You all have jotted down the questions. You all have taken it down, the questions in your copies. And you see this video, you see the, you go through the chapter thoroughly, and then you will start writing the answers. So I hope you will write. You all will be able to write. I know this. You all will be able to write all these answers. If you all have any problem, you all can let us know. Okay. So now you all can start with your answers. And so till here we have finished. So this is all for today. So bye children. Take care and thanks for watching the video.